When you are using EndNote to organize and cite your references, one of the most important steps you will need to do is to create your EndNote library. In this video, I will be showing you how to create your EndNote library on both Windows and macOS and some of the things you need to be aware of. Your EndNote library is the foundation block when using EndNote, as it stores all your references that you brought into EndNote. The size of your EndNote library is determined by your hard disk space. Clarivate Analytics recommends that you do not exceed 100,000 references. We also recommend that you only have one EndNote library to store all your references unless you are doing a systematic review. If you are doing a systematic review using EndNote, please speak to your librarian for assistance. A .data folder and an .enl file will be created when you create your EndNote library. Please keep them together if you plan on transferring them to another device or if you want to back up your EndNote library. To create your EndNote library, first open up EndNote. If you are a new user, you will be prompted to create a new EndNote library automatically. If that does not happen, click on File and then click on New. Key in the name of your EndNote library and then click on Save. You will notice that EndNote will create a .data folder and an .enl file. The folder and file stores your references that are in the EndNote library. Please do not delete them and always keep them together if you are transferring them or doing a backup. For EndNote users who are on a Mac, the steps to create your EndNote library is similar to the PC version. Mac EndNote users have an option to save their EndNote library as a .enlp package file, which combines the .data folder and the .enl file as a single file. However, do note that the .enlp file can only be read by a Mac version of EndNote. If you are using different devices on different operating systems, please do not save your EndNote library as a .enlp file. Like the Windows version of EndNote, first open up EndNote. Click on File and then New. You can then name your EndNote library and EndNote will create a .data folder and an .enl file. If you want to save it as a .enlp package file, check the option to save it as a package and a .enlp file will be created. I hope that this video has shown you how you can create your EndNote library. If you want to know more about EndNote, please visit our EndNote library guide. You can also email us at askalib@nus.edu.sg if you need further assistance.